Hi everyone, it's Tanya. I am here today to film a video on a new craft I've never tried before. It's going to be these flowers that I got. I'm going to turn them into a floral garland. So it's going to be basically all these flower buds. I'm going to cut them and then thread them into a string of flowers. So they're gonna dry out, and from what I hear, they're not gonna all keep their color, but we'll see. It depends on the kind of flower, and I guess also how much light is exposed to it. So I'm gonna try to dry it in a cool, dark place and see how they turn out. So I followed a couple of sites that were suggesting to find a string or to thread a string and then throw the flowers through halfway through it. And so I've to eliminate some time, I've already threaded this embroidery string here with the thread, and I'm just going to go ahead and start on this now. So yeah, come join me. We'll see how this goes. So I'm going to start with, where should I start? Oh wow, some of them already dried. I'll start here. I like this yellow one. Maybe I'll start with the pink one. I'll start with the carnation. Where's my thread? I guess I'm gonna try going at an angle, because if they're gonna dry, let's see how this goes. Oh, came out. I guess that's gonna happen because I don't want to put a knot through it. Maybe you should do a steeper angle. Where are you? Stay here. So we'll go with the next one. You know what? I'm going to put the bigger ones in the middle, maybe. I'll get another purple one. We'll go for a smaller guy. Or gal. Over here. This one was the smaller one, so it was kind of hard to get an angle. It's kind of cool. Coming together. Only did two, so. Alright, guys, stay here. I got these flowers on sale after Valentine's Day, so trying to get a little, save a little money here and there. Trying to thread it through the larger part of the, it smells nice, through the larger part of the flower. I can't remember what this part is called, but the, I don't know, piston? No, that's not right. No, piston is in the inside, I believe. Yeah, but I'm trying to, right before it turns into the stem. I guess it's part of the stem. I need to freshen up on my biology, clearly. This yellow one is so pretty. closer. All right, we'll get another carnation here. It feels kind of bad, like, cutting these flowers when they're still fresh, but I want to get them when they're still in their collar, because they're starting to dry and droop down a little, and I'm hoping if I catch them before they all dry up, then maybe they'll hold some of their color. That's what my hopes are. Oh, it looks cool. I'm wondering if I should choose. Let's see. Where should I go next? I should get one that's similar in size. And this one is starting to. It's already started to dry off. The stem. I wish I knew the names of these flowers. I'm not really good with the names of flowers. Except I know which ones are carnations. And the yellow ones kind of look like daisies, but I'm not sure if they're daisies or not. Get this guy right here, but I feel like I'm gonna have to wrap it because it's a long one. Let's see, it looks like it would smell like something, but kind of just smells like flowers. It's bad, right? No, it's not bad, but my vocabulary. I need to work on my vocabulary. Let's see, where am I gonna go next? Gonna be super long. Maybe I will go through I'll go through the end here, and then I'm gonna kind of wrap it around in between the flowers. This goes. I don't really know what I'm doing. Can you tell? Let's see. All right, I'm gonna stem it through here. Let's see how this goes. I'm also hoping that the petals don't fall off. I have a lot of high hopes. Let's see. Come through here. It's already starting to sound crispy like paper. I'm not sure if you can hear that sound. Well, I'm already running low on bread. I might have to go through the other side. Or tie a knot to the end of this thread. I have to figure something out here because this is it's getting a little tight. Running out of real estate. I wanted to do this for a long time, but I'm not really like the kind of person who buys flowers. So, I actually have a garden, and in the garden are my mom's old rose bushes. So I do dry out rose petals, but I've kind of been drying them out for a craft, which I haven't yet found a use. I haven't found a craft for. I've just been drying them out. I like to collect crafts, so what can I say? I know I'm not the only one. There are other other people out here doing the same thing, I'm sure. I've heard the meme going around, so. Yeah. That looks pretty. Almost kind of looks like a lei or something, you know? Except it's not the vibrant colors of Hawaii, of the Hawaiian leis. Never been to Hawaii. Love to go someday. Looking interesting. Oh my gosh, they're so pretty. I wish I could keep the color. I think I'm expecting a lot, but see, some of these flowers are already drooped and lost a lot of their petals, so larger purple one. More carnations. Pretty cool. Oh, see? I guess if you rotate them a little, they kind of stagger. See, I should have put it up there, I guess. But we'll see if I can go back later maybe and correct them. Maybe I can get another thread going and kind of like rotate them around the thread. So that there'll be more coverage. I just won't see so much of the string. Oh, see? Now that guy's moving. I'm gonna have to fix that. Get this little guy here. I don't know why I keep calling you guys. But, I mean, I guess. What do I know? I'm just a crafter. Let's see. Where am I going next? Okay. Again. Oh. Ow. Oops. You're my doggy. I have a little puppy downstairs. I had to leave them downstairs because they don't like it when I craft. They want all the attention, especially the puppy. He's like very, okay, I'm going for the yellow one. Yeah, the puppy is very, he's very thirsty. He's very thirsty for attention, you know? He wants all attention on him. And he gets very jealous. They say that dogs get jealous. That is the one emotion. It's the one emotion that they share with humans. Or one of the emotions. Is that right? I don't know. I didn't read the article. Let's see. Oh my gosh. Ah, so pretty. I'm loving it. Let's see. Okay, we're gonna go here. This is a big one. It's gonna overshadow the pretty yellow one that I like. There was only two yellow ones in this bunch here. The yellow one I keep referring to that looks like a daisy.
the yellow one, but
what can we do? I'm just going with the flow.
Oh my goodness.
It feels bad, but it's not like I'm killing the flower, you know? It's already been cut. So I just kind of feel bad because they're still attached to a stem. Like a huge carnation. Boom. Boom, shalak, lak, boom. All right, so much for the diagonal threading idea. I'm going straight in at a 90 degree angle at this point. Alright, I should show what I'm doing more, right? Because that's the idea of filming, right? Okay. This lady. It's a lady, okay? I'm going to switch it up just because I need to be fair. Okay. I lost the threading. But the show must go on.
Yeah. See?
Okay. I'm gonna re-thread. Oh. Re-threading in action. There we go. Almost. One is not in there. When I was younger, I was always the one in the house whose job it was to thread the needle. That was my job. I had one job. We all have one job, right? At a time, at least. If we're multitaskers, we have more than one job. Oh, come on. Oh, there we go. Boom. All right. Where should we go now? I'm running out of thread. This is like, I guess I was thinking it was going to. I don't know what I was thinking. I'm like really running out of thread. Don't tell me it's. Almost. It's almost out. Yeah, almost lost the threading again. Okay, I need to show more what I'm doing. It looks like there's a lot of space here. Yeah, I guess that's just gonna be, I'll just go with it. I'm just gonna keep rolling. Rolling with the homies. Anybody remember what that's from? Comment down below. It's definitely dating me, that's for sure. Carbon dating. Oops. I keep forgetting to show the actual threading part. Alright, I'm not going to forget now because I said it out loud. These little guys here. Guys and gals. Okay. So I'm threading. It's going through. See, this is where it's losing the thread here. Okay. I'm pushing it through the flower. I'm holding the thread so it doesn't unthread. And I'm holding it up so you can see. See how I'm kind of rotating it so it, you don't see they're not all in a line like soldiers, but kind of, I don't know how to compare it, what to compare it to, but kind of rotating in like a DNA strand. Getting scientific on you guys. I wish I could angle this back. Maybe I'll do this. I'll push it back so you can see more. You don't need to see all my pores. Too much information. Can you see? Okay. I'm holding the thread and pulling it down and rotating at the same time. It's like a nice cluster here of this same flower. Where should we go next? Maybe, what do you think? Let's see. It's so pretty. Oh my gosh. This is like real hippie stuff here, right? Oh my gosh, I could do like a looky. Okay, I'm not. That's not the purpose of this craft. This is just for decoration. I don't think I mentioned that, did I? It's a garland, so, but yeah, I'm gonna string these on the fireplace, like kind of underneath the fireplace. Or I was also thinking like above a doorway, like the front door, kind of like the arch of the door. So I am going back for the same flower again, but I think I need to start mixing it up a little bit. So now I'm going to get a different one. I'm running low on space already. Do you hear my puppy? It's kind of sad. Like, he's crying. You know, it makes me feel like a bad mom. I just fed them and walked them, so I did tend to their needs before I started this project. So, I'm not a bad mom. But it sounds like it. Like, it just tugs at my heartstrings. Is that the word? Oh my gosh. It's so cool. Okay, alright. I don't think I'm doing too bad for a first time project. Not too bad. Right, okay, yeah, you can see some stems there, but yeah, no, it's not going to be perfect. It's, I don't know what the term is. There's a Japanese term for it. I want to say wabi-sabi, but I'm not sure. Comment below if you can help me out with this one. Organic, we'll say. It's organic. It's not perfect. It's not, you know, perfection. And nothing is. And when you're creating, you know, it should be fun. Especially when you're working with nature. In this case. You know what I'm going to end up doing is threading the other end. So yeah, this is the halfway point I started threading through. But I think I'm going to end up threading on the other side. If that makes sense. Okay. So yeah, I tied a knot here. And it's said to thread through half, so I wonder if that's why they said. I didn't finish reading the article. I have a little ADD, so not diagnosed. I'm not diagnosed with ADD, but, you know. Oh my gosh. As my uncle would say, we all have ADD. Or maybe he meant all of us in the family. I don't know. Let's see. I'm gonna do one more on this side, and then I'm gonna turn it and thread on this side. So I'm gonna thread this side, and then, you know, thread the flowers to the other half. All right, so there's so many of these flowers. I think that's why I keep going for them. There's a lot of this type of flower. I'm not sure what it is. I will find out someday. Okay, this is the last one for this side. So I'm leaving a little bit of string here, so I can, I don't know, I guess there's got to be something, some way of, I'm just tying a knot off here at the end. There's something that's off film here. Yeah, I'm going to, I don't know what I was going to say here. Tie a knot. Oh yeah. I guess I should have some, leaving some give so that I can have some string I can attach to however I'm going to, you know, like create a loop or something with the remainder of this thread so that I can attach it to the wall somehow or the fireplace or wherever. Oh my gosh, it's all pretty. All right, so I'm gonna thread this side and then I'm gonna continue with, he's really crying. I'm going to continue with the other side. I might cut this part out. Oh no, where did I put the thread? There it is. I'm going to cut this part out of the video. I'm not sure. Let's look at. A little petal. Having fun, guys. Thank you for joining me. If you've stayed this long, I appreciate you. Well, this is like a long video. I see it's like, I'm not gonna say the marker, but I mean, yeah, time. Okay, so I got another one of these pretty ones that, I don't know, maybe somebody knows what they are. They're so pretty. They're like yellow and orange and black in the middle. I used to know the name of this because I actually did a painting of something of one of these flowers, but it was purple. It's actually behind me. The painting, not the flower. Yeah, that's some similar kind of patterning, so I'm thinking it's the same flower, just a different color. So here we are. Started I started on the other end, so it looks like the middle part is like narrower. Maybe I'll do that other flower that's just like it in that narrow part. Do it the same way. I'm just going to thread through and then kind of wrap around in between the flowers. Oops. Oops. Nope. Not a good way to do that. I guess. There we go. Okay, and come through. And I'm just going to kind of in and out as I get towards the end. I'm not sure what this is going to look like either as it dries, because there's going to be more space in between. Right now the flower petals are filling in a lot of the space, but as it dries, like, it's going to, you know, like, flowers wilt, and so it's not going to keep its form. Okay, so let's see, where should I go next? I guess I'll get another one of these purple ones. Oh wow, there's some big ones on here I haven't gotten yet. I wonder if I should save those for another project. Talking about these here. This big one right here, can you see? It's really pretty. It's like yellow in the middle. What should I go here? What do you think? Alright, you know what? I'm gonna go. I think they're too big. I'm gonna save these for another project. There's this one over here too. It's also very large. That would make a really pretty flower for like your hair or something. Not that I do that kind of thing, but I can see it for that use. All right, so like I'll just keep going with these other flowers until I can figure out what to do with those other ones. So I'm just rolling with the homies here. With the homies. To this big carnation here. It's so pretty. Oh my gosh. I'm hoping the flower petals won't fall out too if I dry them and just don't come near them as they dry, hopefully. The petals won't drop off. That's a huge one. Okay, where am I going next? Maybe I'll get semi-huge one. Big carnations again. I do know that this is a carnation. I actually am a gardener, guys, okay? So yeah, I know it doesn't seem like I know anything about what I'm doing. I'm just not, this is crafting, so it's different than gardening, but I actually do garden, so I'm more of a vegetable gardener than a flower gardener though, so. Just moving right along. Moving right along. Anybody know what that's from? Yeah, see, it's like still kind of narrow there in the middle, but at least, you know what? It's kind of centered a little. Going for a little centered action there. Go for this guy. This is fun. I think I'm gonna do this again. I can already tell I'm enjoying this. And it's a good way to like re it's a good way to keep the flowers, you know, that you have, so you can still enjoy them long after they have lived. You know? It's beautiful at the same time. Fun to make, beautiful to keep. Almost lost the thread again. Almost. Okay. All right, I'm low on flowers now. I'm gonna do a couple of these pink ones, and I think that might be it. Because again, I'm gonna keep these large ones for something. I don't know. I'm gonna Google, see what I can use those for. I'm definitely gonna do these with the roses that grow in my garden because, you know, it's like a nostalgic thing. My mother planted those rose bushes outside, and be a good way to keep her memory going, other than, you know, just keeping the rose bush going, keeping her memory alive. Rest in peace, my mama. All right, we're reaching the end point here. So I'm going to finish up these pink ones. Maybe put a couple more of the purple ones that are most that I used. Actually, this bouquet had a lot of, but I use a lot on the garland here of them. Actually, a lot more left of the small purple ones. I'm gonna finish.
brush them off. And then I'm gonna find a place for this to dry. Some of the ones that haven't bloomed yet, just to add a little variety and texture. But we'll see how this goes. Maybe I'll go back later and add some somehow. Look, guys, that's it. Isn't it? Yeah. There are any more small ones? Look. Looky, looky. Oh my goodness. So pretty. It does kind of remind me of a lei, a Hawaiian lei. It does. Oh my gosh, I love it. Okay, so I'm going to tie off the ends. Well, this end. The other one's tied off already. And then I'm going to create a loop. And then find a place for this to dry. And then that will be it for this project. It's been fun. I hope you had fun too watching. Hopefully we all learned something today. Sounding like Mr. Rogers a little. So I'm gonna, let's see, I'm gonna create a loop. Just tying, I got a petal in there. I'm gonna make a loop and then I'm going to find a thumbtack. I have many thumbtacks. Here we go. Some of the petals are starting to fall off, so I'm gonna have to find a location for this, where I can just leave it be, and then that is it. Okay, I'm gonna step back. You see? Oh my goodness! Great. I didn't put a hoop on that side, so I'm definitely gonna have to hang it from this side. Yeah, and that's it. Thanks for coming along on this project. Yeah, next time I'll put a little bit more thought into maybe the form of it, but it was kind of fun just like going with the flow, you know? All right, thank you everybody, love you, bye.